I am Mukarman, will be your host this evening. Alongside me and my co-host, we are Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good evening, everyone. On this pleasant evening, I am here to welcome you all to the International Children's Day 2021. This COVID-19 has really changed everything around the world. From our basic routine way of living, the celebration of big events has suddenly shifted to new normal. Thank you, Karan. Dignitaries, respected principal, deputy principal, vice principals, sectional heads, librarian, teachers, philosophians, parents, ladies and gentlemen. Today, the 1st of October is a special day for children worldwide as International Children's Day celebrated around the globe. This year, marking this special day, the budding writers of Zahira College will be felicitated as we unveil their talents. They have been down their creative thoughts and ideas, not only displaying their skills, but also offering pleasure and enjoyment to readers of all ages. Therefore, to mark this special day at Zahira, our own writers will be launching their work. In order to commence today's proceedings, I'd like to invite Master Abdul Hasib ibn Uthman for the recitation of an extract from the Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان صدق الله العظيم.
Thank you, brother. And next, please rise for the national anthem followed by the college song. Thank you. And now, 1 minute silence, remembering all the children who have lost their lives due to coronavirus.
Thank you.
Next, I kindly invite Mr. Ghazi Mohideen, Vice Principal of the English section, to give the welcome.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Today's chief guest, Mr. Hashim Omar, former director of ITN, Board of Governors, Mr. Fauzul Hamid, and members of the Board of Governors, former Supreme Court Justice, Honorable Salim Marshoof, respected principal, sir, deputy principal, vice principals, head of primary, former deputy principal, and the former vice principal, the three speakers for today who have taken time off their busy schedule to be with us here, Mr. Ahmad M. Hussain, attorney at law, Mr. Kamal, secretary to the Writers Organization of Sri Lanka, Mrs. Farzana Jabir, principal, Harcourt's College, sectional head, my dearest colleagues in the English section, who have been passionately involved in grooming this young generation of writers, and all members of the academic staff, former members of the college staff, secretary to the principal, prefect of discipline, librarian Mrs. Anoja Sarasingha, and all the members of the non-academic staff. Mr. Azri Nahas, who never hesitated to provide us with support organizing this event, and also the members of the Zahira University alumni. Secretary and members of the Parents Teachers Association, secretary and members of the Old Boys Association, Mr. Ruzaik Farooq, and Mr. Insaf Salahuddin from the media, who helped us immensely in organizing this event. Parents of my beloved writers, who inspired their children to achieve what they have achieved today. All the parents, distinguished guests, my beloved writers, and all the other extremely talented and passionate students of the English section, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, and a very good afternoon to all of you. It gives me immense honor and privilege to welcome you all to this e-book launching organized to celebrate the International Children's Day 2021. As we all agree, the students of a school are the most part of the smooth functioning of a school, and it's indeed the students who make a school lively and flourishing. We as the English section value our students immensely and are extremely honored of their accomplishments. This year alone, 26 young writers of our section who wrote 26 different books on various themes, out of which 12 books are set to be launched today. Azan. These 12 talented writers aren't the first group of writers who are launching their books in from our college. In fact, we, the English section, alone had launched books to mark the International Children's Day for the past 3 years. And this year too, although the pandemic doesn't permit us to gather together and hold the big ceremonial launch, our students have shown their fighting spirit by fighting the pandemic and associated stress with their pen. Also, we know the English section of Zahira College was the last section to be added to the college, the section that started with 35 students and just two teachers, Mrs. Kamila Osman and I. On the 5th of February 1998, as an initiative of the then principal, Professor M.T.A. Furkan has expanded today to become the section that accounts to around half of the college students' population. Our first O-level batch, we had only 18 students. Out of that, only 15 students who came from grade 1 onwards to the college. As a starting member of the English section, and as someone who has seen it grow over the past years, I extremely honored that the section within past space of 25 years has now achieved all it has. These achievements have all been as a result of the hard work and commitment of many people, like the principals, management members, students, and most importantly, the teachers who have served and contributed immensely to this section. May Almighty Allah bless all of them. And let me once again congratulate our writers and warmly welcome all of you to this very important event. Wahid Dawana, Anilhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Thank you, madam. Please be informed that the viewers who had joined using the Zoom can rejoin using the same link, and also this is being live streamed via Facebook page of Zahira University alumni. And next on our agenda will be the person who has consumed himself to change the society and light the darkness in the life of your children. Our principal, Mr. Trizi Marikar, to address the audience.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Chairman Board of Governors, members of the Board of Governors, all the special invitees, our special guest, Mr. Omar, and all the guests who have been invited to review the books. Yep. members in the EXCO of the Parents Teachers Association, senior members of the management of the college, teachers, parents, students. It is indeed a great moment for Zahira College as we are launching a set of books. Those books are launched as an e-book on this International Children's Day. I hope it is indeed a great moment
we're disappointed. Excuse me, sir, we cannot hear you.
Excuse me, sir. Principal, sir.
Can you hear me?
You can continue, sir.
Can you hear me?
We can hear you, sir. Now you can continue.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. All the special guests and guest of honors, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I would like to start from the beginning. May I thank each and every one of you who have joined here to celebrate the International Children's Day. This is commemorated today at Zahira College under different sections. So many programs were conducted throughout the day, and we are now here with the main program organized by the English section of the college. And it is a proud moment for all of us, as the Vice Principal for English section reiterated, the English section is the newly added section. Over the last 25 years, it has been serving the country with the products of its own. And On this day that the theme we have selected, Unite to Reverse the Impact of COVID-19 Pandemic on Children. Now, the children are the most important segment in a society, and there is no exception. And today, we are facing a pandemic situation where the right of education for the children is denied globally. And facing the challenges, the children have come forward to accept the challenge along with the teachers and the parents to address their own issue. At a time like this, writing books and launching those books in the form of e-books are a welcome move. Not only this time, even the last year, they wrote large number of books under the government-sponsored program. Today, keeping to the theme, the children have done extremely well in launching these sets of books. Around 12 books are going to be launched, and they have written much more than that. It is my pleasant duty of congratulating all of them for their hard work and also making use of the time that they had at home. And also, it is my duty to thank the teachers who guided them and molded them to be the budding writers. Now, great writers will start in a small, would have started their life in a small manner. And I see that these children are also getting into that road. In fact, education is not only learning inside the classroom, confined to the classroom, four walls of the classroom, that they have to see that there is much more that they can achieve in their life. And it is our duty to make available the opportunities for them to widen their horizon, widen their imagination. The skills of imagination is very, very important. And we know the writers are very sensitive people. The country and world lacks the sensitive people to serve the humanity. That is why we would like to see the children engage in aesthetic activities. So today's context, the most important thing is to see that we prepare good human beings who are good enough to serve the humanity. Zahira College, we here are trying to put our efforts, put our heart and soul together to work for the children at a very extreme difficult situation in order to achieve our goals. All three mediums, Sinhala, Tamil and English, they are working very hard to develop their language skills. It is very important, more than anything, the communication skills to be developed, that language skill has to be developed. And this is one effort that the children have taken care of. In fact, when we designed the International Children's Day program, all credit should go to the English section for making a great event of this nature and to get all the stakeholders and Zahirians and all the children and the staff together in this manner. I have been participating in many programs from the morning, and each of the sections, they are dedicated in working with the children on this day. Ladies and gentlemen, we should try and work hard to help our younger generation. We know when the children lose the school days, you can never, ever get those days back. It is not only learning inside the classroom, as I told earlier. It is the time that they spend in the classes, in the playground, in the library, in the labs, and so on and so forth. Those days they are losing. And those days will never come. So it is very, very sad situation that we are unable to provide them these losing days of their childhood experiences. So they normally come to school not only for learning, they also come for fun, play, and get engaged and get the socialization process going. So when they grow adult, this will have some impact. So it is our duty to provide all those opportunities somehow or other so that these children, when they grow old, when they grow into their adulthood, that they will be good human beings. So these are not just mere efforts of writing books, but getting them into their imaginative world. And though they are unable to come out of their places, the themes that they have selected in delivering, in writing, in going into their selected genre of arts, that we see that they have done extremely well. So we are thanking the parents who dedicated themselves and sacrificed their time in order to see that their children are doing well, and the teachers. And also I should not forget the Board of Governors, All Boys Association, Parents Teachers Association, they are all with us to help the college. So I do not want to take much of my time, but only thing for the parents, I would like to request, please provide all the support to your children and also the staff of the college. As a team, let us work and develop their skills and to make one day a very good human being who are the people going to march the world in the next century. Thank you very much. May the Almighty Allah bless all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for those inspiring words of wisdom. In order to review the novels that will be launched this evening, we have the Secretary of the Writers Organization of Sri Lanka, who is also an executive committee member of Mass Guiding Artists, a writer, journalist, and critic, Mr. Kamal Pereira. I'd like to invite you to do the honors.
Thank you, Isan. I think you can hear me now. Can you hear me, please? Hello?
Yes, sir. We can hear you, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can, sir.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much for the kind opportunity to give me participate in this event, especially International Children's Day, celebration of International Children's Day. And I think today is the day that we celebrate elders also. So as an elder writer, I think you have selected me for that job. So I'd like to give my thanks for that also. The principal of the Saira College and the staff and the guests, I would like to express some ideas regarding your books now. So I think, first of all, I would like to thank especially Mrs. Chandrakala and Ms. Mrs. Chandrakanti for inviting me for this occasion. I think I have four books already. I read them. One in Sinhala. It is written by Asmat Askin. It is named Vasangate Addutu Ma. I think the meaning in English is epidemic experience by me. So I think it is in Sinhala. Therefore, I would like to give some ideas, make some views in Sinhala as it is written by Sinhala. Hito tuni, taru vidhalpati tumani, arati tamuttani, me avasthav mamahitanwa yadiyantara namadinaya සැමරීමට සහිර විද්‍යාලය ගත් ඉතාම වැදගත් පියවරක් එනිසා මම එය සංවිධානය කළ සියලුම විදුහල්පතිතුමා ඇතුළු සියලුම ගුරුමණ්ඩලයේ සමාජිකයන්ට විශේෂම මේ අවස්ථාව සඳහා මා සම්බන්ධ කරත් චන්ද්‍රකලා සහ චන්ද්‍රකාන්ති යන එම හිතවතුන් දෙදෙනාටත් මම ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙනවා මම මෙතන කාලේ ඉතා සීමිත නිසා දීර්ඝ වශයෙන් කතා කරන්න අවස්ථාවක් නැහැ කොහොම නමුත් මේ COVID වදුරක් පවතින මේ වගේ කාලයක නිවස්වල සිටින දරුවන්ට උන්ගේ නිර්මාණ කුසලතා අවදි කිරීම සඳහා අවස්ථාව ලබා දීම අධ්‍යාපනය පැත්තෙන් පමණක් නොව රටේ පුරවැසියන් හැටියටත් ඔබලා යුතු කළ ඉතාම වැදගත් මෙහෙවරක් හැටියට මම සලකනවා මේ දරුවන්ගේ නිර්මාණ දිහා බලපුවහම මට පෙනුණා ඔවුන් ඉතාම දක්ෂ සහ ඉතාම නිර්මාණශීලී දරුවන් බව විශේෂයෙන්ම මට ලැබුණු ඒ පොත් හතර කියවද්දී මම තේරුම් ගත්තා ඔවුන්ට සමාජය ගැන ලෝකය ගැන හොඳ අවබෝධයක් වගේම තම මානව හිතවාදී දැක්මකුත් මේ දරුවන්ට තියෙන බව මම හිතන්නේ ඒක තමයි මේ යුගයේ අවශ්‍යතාවය මොකද අනාගතයේ බාර ගන්න දෙන પરම්පරාව ලෝකයේ දිහා මානව හිතවාදීන් සහ දයානුකම්පාවෙන් යුතුව බලනවා කියන එක ඉතාම වැදගත් කාරණයක් අස්මත් අස්කින් කියන ඒ දරුවා වසංගතේ අද්දුතුමා කියන ඒ කතාවේ ඊටම වැදගත් කාරණයක් අවධාරණය කරනවා මොකද වර්තමාන සමාජයේ අපි මුහුණ දෙන බරපතල ප්‍රශ්නය වන මේ කොවිඩ් වසංගතය ඉදිරියේ කොහොමද අපි කටයුතු කරන්න ඕනේ කියන එක මම හිතන්නේ ඊටම කාලීන මාතෘකාවක් ඊටම කාලීන මාතෘකාවක් ඊටම ආදර්ශමත් විදියට ගුවේ කතාව ප්‍රබන්ධ කරලා තියෙනවා එහි අපිට හමු වෙනවා චරිත දෙකක් ලක්ෂ්මන් විරක්පොඩි සහ ධර්මසිරි කියලා මිතුරන් දෙදෙනෙක් දෙදෙනා වෛද්‍යවරු ඔවුන් කොවිඩ් වදුරින් මේ සමාජයේ මුදවා ගැනීම සඳහා විශාල මෙහෙවරක් කරනවා ඉතින් මේ මෙහෙවර ඉතාම සාර්ථක වෙනවා මොකද මේ ලක්ෂ්මන් විරක්පොඩි කියන ඒ වෛද්‍යවරයාටත් කොවිඩ් වදුර වැළඳෙනවා නමුත් එහෙම වැළඳුණත් ඔහු පසුබට වෙන්නේ නැහැ ඔහු තමන් සුවපත් වුවහම නැවතත් ඔහුගේ මෙහෙවරට ඉදිරිපත් වෙනවා ඉතින් මම හිතනවා මේ වගේ කාලයක ඉතාම වටිනා ආදර්ශයක් අපේ මේ දරුවා අස්මත් හස්කින් වසංගති අද්දුතු මා කියන ඒ කෘතිය මගින් අපිට දීලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් ඒ නිසා මම හිතනවා ඔහුව දිරිගැන්වීම අපිට අවශ්‍යයි. ඔහුගේ උත්සාහය අපි අගය කළ යුතුයි. ඒ නිසා මම සුභපතනවා ඒ දරුවට දීර්ඝ වශයෙන් කතා ගන්න අවස්ථාවක් නැතත් මම සුභාංශිස්සට පිරිනමන්න කැමතියි. Let me speak a few words in English about the Asmat Askin's story. I think it can be appreciated as a fiction with the theme of humanistic features, and it's a contemporary ideas also written by him. I think as a writer, as a newcoming writer, he has done a great job. So I think I like to speak about the second book that is written by English. Name is Lester and Santa by Bilal Yunus. Bilal Yunus also, we can see his talents also very well. He's trying to give some ideas and some views of the society and the background as well. So this is, I think, this can be introduced as an adventure story. Adventure means we meet two heroic boys in this story. They are always trying to do something new. They want to show to the society, they want to change this society, and they need the very what you call a very legally corrected society. So they one time they bring a dangerous criminal to the justice. Then we can call the story, we can see they are trying to encourage the youth. We know that always some boys and girls in the society wasting their time. They are doing unnecessary things sometimes. So this boy, our writer, Bilal Yunus, guide us to do some service, valuable service to the society. I think that view is very kind, very, very useful, and very advantage. So I think we must appreciate this, our son, Bilal Yunus. I like to wish him a good future. The Hidden Success Behind Everything, that is written by Abdul Majid. That also a story we can find encouraging writing style. That means this boy, our boy, our writer, he needs to encourage people in the society. Always he fight against the problems without any hesitation. That is his character's main value. He always want to, as our earlier writer, his view is always do something good, do some valuable thing to the society. So this character called Marcus, he's fighting against problems, and he's fighting against unjust, and finally he got success. So Abdul Majid, this is a very this writer's according to his ideas, the secret is of this success. That means Marcus' success is always encouraging other people and doing some good things. So I think this is also a good idea. And this also he is trying to show us, the readers especially, we must always try to do, try to face problems and success them. If we go backward, we can't do anything and we can't get success. So I think this is also a very encouraging story and very nice writer. So I appreciate our son Abdul Majid also. I wish him a good future. Then I got another book. It is named as Dragon Tales. This is a little short, this some mystery story type in this book. We meet a small boy. He also a little stubborn boy. His name is James. James meets some adventures, and he found a magical ring. So that way, there are many stories like that. That is one story. There are some more stories connected with this extraordinary boy. I think that our Ajmal Rashad's writing always shows us the science of mystery fiction. So our boy, I think he is he's always
excuse me, sir. You still have 1 more minute remaining, that we'll have to mute you in case the time exceeds. Let me mute you, sorry.
Excuse me, sir. Your mic is on mute.
Right, okay. Can you hear? I'm going to finish. And also, I would like to make a kind request from the college authority. Please arrange a literary workshop for these students who engage in creative writing. It will be a great opportunity for them to develop their capacities. So wish you all a good tomorrow. Thank you again. Finally, I would like to mention a little poem written by Rabindranath Tagore for finish my end of my speech. In Sinhala, that means of that poem is like this. Sielu pasasum pavaradi malatam sulanga nihandava paturai malsugande dasatam. I think you can understand. That means in English, all compliments assigned to the flower itself, the wind spreads.
Thank you, Sam. Really sorry to interrupt, but we'll have to mute you because we have to continue with the other programs. Now, I take pleasure in inviting Senior Attorney at Law, Mr. Ahmed M. Hussain, to share his reviews on the short stories. Sir, could you please unmute your mic and talk?
Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you loud and clear.
Yes, yes. Distinguished guest, Board of Governors, Principal, Vice Principal, members of Writers Forum, teachers, parents, old boys, and my dear students of Zaira College, Assalamu alaikum. I consider myself privileged to grace this e-book launch in commemoration of the International Children's Day 2021 at Zaira College and review the three short story books which were placed first, second, and third. Toward this end, I have selected what I consider the best story in each of the three books I have reviewed. The short story book titled Never Say Never, written by Ikram Sajjad, comprising 8 stories, was placed first. In my perception, the short story style, Full Moon Rises on the Poet Day, was the best among that 8 stories. It revolved around a poor boy by name of Ruan, who faced untold difficulties which he was able to overcome owing to the motherly care and encouragement showered on him by his class teacher. In reciprocation, Ruan strove himself using all his energy to rise and aspire to the level that was expected by him by his teacher. Ruan was able to achieve high academic honors as a result thereof and attributed his success to the motherly care and benevolence shown by the teacher. Akin to such munificence is the role displayed by Mrs. Ijazi Mohideen, Vice Principal of English Section, who has proved an admirable mentor to her students. Securing second place was book titled My Stick Book, containing 8 stories. The surprise theme of all those stories being the horror impact, authored by Suhaim Sajjad, in which book the story title Room 1046 was the best in my reckoning. The story revolves around a man by the name of Ronald Owen, who checks into a hotel one evening with surprisingly virtually no luggage and is given room 1046 for his stay. His behavior was observed by the hotel maid and bellhop, reeked suspiciously of a man with ill intent and who was observed have quarreled by one of 2 other female guests, one whom also bore the same surname as Ronald Owen. In the passage of the story narration, Ronald Owen was murdered in his hotel room 104, which sparked off investigation which revealed that he was operating under pseudonyms, and assiduous investigation brought to light that Ronald Owen was a man of history whose violent death remained unsolved until a woman later claimed that he was her missing son, which the police accepted due to lack of any other evidence, and entire episode remained a mystery. However, the strong vein of mystery running through the story with ironic conclusion that it remained unsolved murder mystery warrants it being placed among the top short stories submitted. Placed third was book authored by Huzaifa Shafraz, titled Emerging Collection of Short Stories, comprising 9 stories. Among these 9 stories, the story title, Don't Leave Me, captured my attention because it both usual and original in concept. The story speaks of a young man named Ben, one day very frighteningly found himself transposed in time to his childhood as a result of seemingly being possessed. The story revealed how in his confused and frightened state of mind, Ben seeks help from his parents and in turn from doctors seeking bring to back to normalcy. The unusual aspect of the story is that it deals with supernatural powers, which are believed only by few, but it provided entertaining reading. This selected audience, both literate and professional, may scoff at the idea and thought to supernatural power, but surprisingly, with our heritage and background, there are surprisingly the large number of people who still believe in supernatural power and ability to have such a power impacting the lives of the ordinary people. In conclusion, I wish to state that competition of this nature are highly desirable and bring out latent literary talent in children. Finally, I trust my views will be shared by you and deeply appreciative of attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. That was indeed motivating and extremely informative. We are so honored and privileged to have you with us today. Next on our agenda is an Arabic poem that will be recited by Master Amir Ahmed.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. As-salatu was-salamu ala sayyidil anbiya'i wal mursaleen wa ala alihim wa sahbihim wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. Amin. الحب أعمى love is blind. الحب أعمى ليس فيه كذاب. الحب أعمى ليس فيه كذاب. والحب بالرحمة كلب جميل. والحب بالرحمة كلب جميل. المال والملك ليس فقط. المال والملك فقط. ليس بحياة المال والملك فقط ليس بحياة ليس بحياة العلم بالفحم سعادة الحياة العلم بالفحم سعادة الحياة Love is blind. There is no lie in it. Love is blind. There is no lie in it. With love and mercy, heart is beautiful. With love and mercy, heart is beautiful. Money and wealth is not only life. Money and wealth is not only life. Knowledge and intelligence is happiness of life. Knowledge and intelligence is happiness of life. Idu tulufatu sa'ida. Happy children, happy children.
Thank you, brother. Now, I cordially invite the chairman of the board of governors, Mr. Fauzul Hamid, to address the gathering.
Reading gives knowledge and power. Our chief guest, guest speakers, principal sir, deputy principals, vice principal, teachers, students, assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. Today the world is changing with the pandemic.
Chairman sir, excuse me.
Yeah.
Something is covering your camera.
My, sorry.
Perfect. Thank you.
World is changing and the pandemic has taught us a new lesson. And today, technology is the teacher. I think ebook launching today definitely going to give you all a big boost in your career. The future is going to be all on technology base. And definitely reading will help you in many ways. And the person who don't read definitely will be outdated in his life. And today you all are lucky because Zahir has given everything for you all during the pandemic. I must thank the principal and his team for organizing this special event. And definitely, this is going to bring your new habit. Last, not the least, never ever give up reading. My little success was reading every day. And please keep reading and enjoy reading. And definitely that is going to give you a great result in time to come. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, sir. Your enlightened words would always enshrine in our hearts. Next on our agenda is drama performed by the talented students of the English section on the topic Singhabahu, which is an extract from the Great 10 Sinhala syllabus, originally performed in 1961 under the direction of Professor Edirivira Sathya. Gentlemen, please sit back and enjoy.
Tomulagatinda bahu belenda vemise tidesinda kurirugi jinda bu
ගුණයෙන් සපිරු මනරම් යුගබා දියහස ඔසවනයුරු නිවිකුම් සිහබා පෙරලුවේය ගල්පුවරු
පුරු පරදිවනේ සොයාගුදුරු මිගිදා එහි සතුසින් නොදනවසේ නත්පුරු දෙකගල පසක වැටි ලෙන හිස්වතිබී අයුරු දෙලිසොවින් ගොසනගා වනමෙතකයි දෙදුරු
ගල්ලෙන බිඳලා ලෙන්දොර හැරලා සිංහබා 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 සිවලි මා ප්‍රිය දියණිය ගල්ලෙන බිඳලා ලෙන්දොර හැරලා ගොසින් හැම දෙන නැතේ කිසිරෙක් මම දැනගතිමි මම සැක කළෙමි සිංහබා 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 ලෙන තුල නොවෙති පෙරලා නොඇති ලෙන තුල නොවෙති පෙරලා නොඇති මම දැනගතිමි මම සැක කළෙමි මම දැනගතිමි මම සැක කළෙමි සුරතල් දියණිය මොල කැටි වදනින් මාසන සන්නිය ආහාර පිසන්නිය කවන්නිය පොවන්නිය මාගෙන බිය වන්නිය වනයේ දුකක් විද ආසන්නිය සොයන්නිය ඇත්ගොසින්ය ඇයි සුදු දුවනිය නුඹවත් නොසිටියේ ඇයි සුදු දුවනිය නුඹවත් නොසිටියේ සොහෝයුරානම් මොල මොල ගතියත් නුඹ මෙන් මුදු නැත සොහෝයුරානම් මොල මොල ගතියත් නුඹ මෙන් මුදු නැත ඔහුගේ අනටද කීකරුවූයේ පෙරලා එන්නේද ඔහුගෙන් ගැල
Thank you, my dear brothers. That was indeed a lovely performance. Now, I take pleasure in inviting the principal of Harcourt's International School, Mrs. Farzana Jabir, to share her reviews on the books of poetry.
Thank you.
Now.
Can you hear me?
Yes, madam. Can hear you. Madam, can you please unmute your mic? Madam, please unmute your mic. You're inaudible.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, madam.
Oh, thank you. The principal, Zahira College, Mr. Prithvi Marikar, deputy principals, sectional heads, staff, students, parents, and distinguished guests. Assalamu alaikum and a pleasant afternoon to all. I wish all the children a happy Universal Children's Day and the elders a happy Elders Day with Allah's blessings. Thank you for inviting me. I'm grateful for Mrs. Shinaz Badruddin, the sectional head for English Senior, for giving me this honor to review the poems written by the boys of this prestigious college. Congratulations and best wishes on the successful launch of e-books of 12 enterprising students of your college, organized by the Writers Forum. It is indeed an accomplishment. I laud the untiring efforts and encouragement of the teachers to motivate these boys to bring out the talent of creative writing to the fore. I shall now review the poetry booklets of 4 boys to the best of my ability. Akif Ahmed, who secured the 3rd place, presents a refreshing outlook, a new perspective to the ordinary things like the pen, water, clock, and to some favorite topics of children such as father, mother, and sister. The diction he had used was simple and good. It brought out the sincerity and goodness he sees around him. The poem Game has novelty and is an excellent poem. Congratulations. Rayhan, who secured the 2nd place, impressed me with a good diction, a unique play of words. I found 3 interesting poems, First Day at School, The Lesson, and The Court. Akhil Ahmed, had an interesting array of titles, the poem's dodo was novel, with flavor, and fine metaphor for coronavirus was unexpectedly delightful. The smartphone depicted a tech-savvy mind. Ostrich was an excellent poem. In fact, it was a perfect poem. Amir Ahmed Mahir's booklet, which was submitted for a government initiative to make students readers and writers of this booklet of 25 poems, astounded me for its variety of topics, imagination, brevity, novelty and freshness. Peace and in Power, Mother Lanka, Nature's Excellence, all had good diction and a fine play of words. His poems are very refreshing.
Excuse me, madam. Two more minutes remaining.
And he seems to have tried a new type of poetry writing. Through his poems, he hopes for a better tomorrows and a better world. A lot of effort time has gone into his writing. To sum up my review of all the booklets, I found it was an amazing collection of poems written in an amusing manner. They were very imaginative and very refreshing in these troubled times. There is an omission of literary devices, yet there is a common thread, a theme that runs through all the poems, such as humor, hope, new thinking, all in the hope of a better tomorrow and a better world. May all your hopes and wishes come true, my dear boys. Congratulations, my dear boys and teachers also. I congratulate you all for this successful launch. I salute you and your accomplishment and wish you all success. May Allah bless you all. Jazakallah khairan.
Thank you, madam. Let us now have the privilege to invite our respected deputy principal, Mr. Razin Azzan, to address the audience.
Hello.
Yes, sir, we can hear you. Sir, please unmute. Sir, please unmute the mic.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah. Dear respected principal of the college, vice principal, sectional heads of English senior section, who had been the backbone of today's program, honorable chairman, board of governors, members of board of governors, chief guest of today's program, Mr. Hashim Omar, members of senior management, including all vice principals, head of primary and sectional heads, invited guests from OBA and PTA, dear parents and audience, above everything, dear heroes of today's program, children, especially those who authored the books that are being launched now. Very happy Children's Day to all of you, and also very happy Elders Day to those who are celebrating Elders Day. Assalamu alaikum. Very good evening. Aibowan and Wanakkam. My dear respected children and audience, book launching, or even e-book launching, electronic book launching, what a smart idea to celebrate an International Children's Day. We know that thousands of children in the island as well as overseas had little or no direction during this pandemic, which has paralyzed almost all spheres of life, including education, health, or economy, or whatever areas, hospitality, or tourism, whatever areas you took has been partly paralyzed by this pandemic. And is that, of course, it had its own impact on the education as well. But alhamdulillah, it's a smart decision made by the English senior section to encourage their young, talented children to write something during this pandemic to make use of their time in a better way. And we had, alhamdulillah, we had almost 26 books written, and four of which 12 books got selected for the final round. It's a great great idea, and not only a great idea, it is something to encourage the young writers to come up with similar things in future. And now very much I have to appreciate the contribution made by the class teacher. Without the encouragement of the class teachers, as well as the contribution or continuous encouragement of the parents, and only resulted in this fruitful endeavors. My dear children, let me once again congratulate all of you. It shouldn't be your first or last book. Your effort should be continued. And not only in writing, but like principal and the chairman said, the reading. Not everybody will be able to write or come up with books, but reading can almost everyone, even the person who is in the street can do reading. So therefore, the reading should be our habit. That only can take all of us into next level of thinking. With that note, let me conclude my speech. Assalamu alaikum. A very good, happy evening to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your words of wisdom. And now, for the most anticipated moment of the evening, we present the video clip of the book launch that was held at the college premises on the 22nd of September, in accordance with the COVID health guidelines and minimum participation.
And now it's time to acknowledge the presentation on young writers.
Thank you.
to pay heartfelt gratitude to those who contribute. To pay heartfelt gratitude to those who contributed in making today's event success, I cordially invite the sectional head of English Senior Section, Mrs. Sheenaz Badruddin, to propose the vote of thanks.
Assalamu alaikum and good evening to everyone. Radiating, reviving is the golden era is back. Leaders, thinkers emerged as a symbol. Zahira means excellence, abiding by its name. Success over success, flattering and flags of faith. Saying that, being the project chairman, I am very much privileged to propose the vote of thanks to conclude this event. First and foremost, I would like to thank the chief guest, Mr. Hashim Umar, Board of Director, Town Hall, Chairman of Board of Governors, Mr. Fauzul Hamid, other members of the Board of Governors for being our special guest, our reviewers, namely Mrs. Farzana Jabir, Mr. Kamal Pereira, Mr. Ahmed Hussein for spending their time to review their books. And our special thanks goes to prominent old boys, Mr. Ruzaik Farooq, being the son of the first librarian of our college, and Mr. Infaz Salahuddin for supporting throughout, including photography and publishing in printed visual media. Thank you very much for your support. And Mr. Azri, coordinator of Zua, being the co-host along with our risk counselor from the college side. I may also like to express our sincere thanks to our college principal, Mr. Trezvi Marika, deputy principal, vice principal, head of primary, prefect of discipline, librarian, head of IT, members of PTA, prize winners, writers, parents, teachers, and my dear students, and all the audience. Big thank to all of you. And this event has very much remarkable and grand success due to streamline through Facebook. So we are giving our special thanks to Zua as well. This event had become a very remarkable day due to first e-invitation, e-book launch, e-live telecast from Zahira Excellence. Happy Children Day and Elders Day as well. Signing off, Sheenaz Badruddin, Sectional Head of ESS. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for listening, for the inspiration, for the encouragement, for being here, and most importantly, for giving your time and making your presence. You're a wonderful audience, and we hope that we have been a good host equally.
Every good thing must come to an end, and we have reached that point of today's proceedings. Thus, to conclude today's event, I would like to request Master Abdul Hasib Nuhman for the recitation of dua and salawat.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت واستغفرك واتوب اليك صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد يا ربي صلي وسلم